Hello, developers. Welcome to today's tutorial, where we'll show you how to create a document scanner app in Power Apps. Let's dive in. Microsoft Power Apps is a low-code development platform that empowers you to craft Canvas apps tailored to your business needs without delving into traditional programming languages. Our focus today is integrating a document scanning service into a Power Automate flow within a Canvas app, leveraging Dynamsoft Service REST API. But before we embark on this journey, let's cover a few prerequisites. For a quick start, we need to download and install Dynamsoft Service on Windows. I'll put the download link in the description below. Then, head over to our GitHub repository to download the example code that establishes a web server for communicating with Dynamsoft Service via REST API. Download the package and run it on your host machine. In the development environment, use a third-party tool to connect the local web server to the internet, thereby making it publicly accessible. The temporarily generated URL, which starts with HTTPS, will be used later in the Canvas app. Confirm that the web server is running by visiting the URL in a browser. Now, let's get started with the Canvas app. Open the Power Apps dashboard and create a new blank Canvas app, giving it a name and selecting the tablet format. Now, let's adorn the screen with some UI elements. Two buttons, a drop-down list, and an image control. Adjust their positions and rename the buttons. The GetDevices button triggers an HTTP GET request to retrieve a list of available scanners. The Scan button triggers an HTTP POST request to initiate document scanning. Moving on to the Power Automate panel, let's craft two flows. For the first flow, name it GetDevices. It starts with an HTTP request step, specifying a GET method, and providing the URL from earlier with a devices path appended. Next, add a Parse JSON step. In the content field, choose body, and add a JSON schema to extract device information. Go on, use select data operation to pull out the device names. We choose the devices as the dynamic content and add two values to make the scanner name visible. To complete the loop, send the selected output back to Power Apps as a response. We also need a JSON schema here to display the device name. Let's save and close it. Next, I will create the second flow. Let's begin with an input. Followed by an HTTP request using a POST method and the URL constructed with the ScanDocument path. In the body field, add the input into the content. Then, add a Parse JSON step. In the content field, choose body and add a JSON schema to parse response and extract the scanned image. Finish the flow by choosing the image as the return value. Okay, the setup is done. I'll name it ScanDocument. With the flows set up, let's link them to our UI elements. for the Get Devices button, assign the following code to its onSelect property. In the Variables panel, under Collections, you'll find all scanners listed. For the dropdown list, assign the device's collection to its items property. Rename it and select the name value to display the scanner's name. Moving on to acquiring a document image, for the scan button, assign the following code to its onSelect property. The data variable will now be populated with the response from the flow, accessible in the Variables panel. Finally, set the image property using the URL of the scanned image, constructed by combining the base URL with the image name. And there you have it. Let's save and run the app. Click Get Devices. Choose a scanner. Click Scan and see the results. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more exciting content. Keep coding, stay creative, and we'll see you in the next tutorial. Bye.